Mongrel should be out from here, you'd think. Corner, break that block out and run out. Yep, beautiful. Perfect. Should be all over. And Jason is struggling here. He's got all his balls are tied up. Oh, Mongrel, bad luck. Just snookered himself. He should have been out. Oh, good. Yep. I think Mongrel just threw this game away. Oh. Sorry. Yep. How's that? Travis just gave Jason two shots, but man, it's going to be tough. Tough to... Can't get that yellow out. Yeah, up and down. Kicked that one in the bum, but good luck with that. It's a hard shot. Well, looks like Jamie might be out. Oh, don't tell me he snookered himself. But he can go across off the bottom rail and out for the black. But man, it's bad luck.
So Richard, I'm joining you in the commentary. This is Kenny Nicol. Yep. And Richard Yonan.
Hey Kenny, how are you, mate?
Good, good.
Setup is beautiful. So Jamie, looks like he's going to go 1-0 against Mongrel. Mongrel should have had that. He made a nice breakout on the black and he pots a ball and snookers himself on one of Jamie's reds. Like, unbelievable. Should have had that game. So it's 1-0 to Jamie Stevens, and we've got a dogfight over here with Travis and Jason. Travis could be out here. He's got to be careful. He doesn't snooker himself. Ooh, that was very lucky, man.
Okay, I'm back. Just needed to get some batteries in the power pack for the headset. So how do we go? We need to update the score anyway?
Yeah, it's Jamie Stevens 1-0 against Mongrel, and looks like 1-0 for Travis Crawley.
Okay. Travis,
so Mongrel had a dry break, and it looks, the yellows look not too bad. If he can just, I can't see the angle, but he could screw back onto that red. Bump that red out. If he can get that yellow into play, if he can, it's pretty hard because he's up in the corner pocket, but if he can get on that red by that, on the yellow, right on top of that one he's making, he's out. No, it's the best he could do. But still, one nice pot and he's out. They're all sitting really nice. Oh, and JT just potted a yellow off the break. No, that looks pretty good.
Yeah, they look good.
Yeah.
Either yellows or reds.
Yeah. Probably reds, yeah, because he hasn't got opener. And
it's a bit short. It made it, though.
Yeah.
And Jamie Stevens won it.
Yeah, geez, if he makes that, he was out. So Mongrel's got a pretty good chance here, you know. If he can get make that red and get get the one on the left-hand side on the bottom cushion, and then up for those two that are tied together. He could be out too. It's a little bit of working around.
So yeah, we'll get rid of those. Oh, okay.
You know, if he makes that, and then
the red in the top left.
Yeah, and then work his way onto that bottom red that's tied up.
Yeah,
he should be out.
Yeah,
or he could break it out here. You know, he's a really good billiards player, Mongrel. So
that's all right.
Yeah, so you can make that bottom one, eh?
Would you though? You'd go the one close to the rail, then you'd go the one.
Yeah. That's what I mean. But if you can get a little bit higher on that,
Yeah.
Now you know he, but he's got to be high, eh? So he can hit it and come off the back cushion.
Yeah.
He should be out. The black is a little bit difficult, eh? It doesn't go anywhere, I don't think.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So he's got to come to the bottom rail and pop it in the corner.
Which corner? The top right corner, you mean?
Yeah, top right corner. It doesn't go on either side or either corner.
That's hard to get right on the bottom rail here.
He needs to do is get that one, the red closest to the black and come off of two rails. And he's capable of that.
Yeah.
That's what I think he's working on now. He's just got to get a nice little angle.
Mm. And going back to JT's game, he's looking good for an out on this one.
Yep, definitely.
So yeah, it's
He's a bit. It's hard to get on that red. If he pots the top one of the two reds that are together, it's going to be hard. Oh, nice shot.
So just letting everyone know that Mongrel and Jamie Stevens' match could be a race to 11. They might have agreed to go higher.
Oh, okay.
So we'll just, we're finding that out now.
Yep. And the money's right, 400 and 500?
It is, yeah.
Yeah,
good. That's a pot. So yep. 200 each and 250 each.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know what he was doing there.
Yeah, me either.
I might have been trying to get the yellow slightly out of the way. It's, you know, like
you know that might ball. You know that might go into the left side, but he may have to screw, take that one in the top right corner and screw back, come off two cushions to get behind that black.
Sorry, guys, with that cough. I thought it was on mute, but it wasn't.
How do you mute it?
At the top, there's a button, mute button.
Oh,
when
yeah.
When you press it, that light will go on.
Yep. Yeah, because I coughed as well. Air is a bit dry here.
Oh, okay, it goes.
Oh, it must go, yeah.
Yeah.
Sorry, folks, it's hard to see the angles.
Yeah, I don't have any diagonal cameras on at the moment.
Yeah. Oh, and that was JT just won, yeah. So it's one all.
Definitely.
That was a nice little out. You have to really control those two reds, the cue ball. Oh, good night. It's all over.
You think so?
Oh, yeah. You know, he makes that yellow on the rail by the black. He screws back, takes it in the other corner, and he's out. And the other ones are shelling peas, mate.
Well, I don't know. I reckon the one behind the black there, not the one over the pocket, but the one behind the black is going to be a bit tough.
What, this one?
Yeah, the one to
no,
the
no,
left.
No, just
black.
Make that second last ball screw back in the corner, and he's out.
Yeah. You make it sound really easy.
It is. I like these guys aren't mugs. They're good players.
Oh,
oh
wow. Nice break.
Yep.
Okay. He's getting rid of those balls first.
Yeah, see, I don't know. I would have played for that one in the side. Oh, I see what he's going to do. He's going to make that and bump the black out. But
really?
he'll
bump the yellow out.
That was the problem with that shot.
Yeah, you kill the black, but
yeah, but I don't know if that yellow goes inside. You know, I wouldn't have done it that way.
He looked like he had a little bit of bottom, maybe bottom left or something, just to pop into that yellow to move it to the center of the table.
Well, yeah, but you know, he didn't even have to do that. All he had to do was play that ball last, second last, and screw back for the one that's right by his hand. into the other corner and see you later, right?
Yeah, okay. Good point. Oh, missed that by a long way.
Yeah, he just butchered that.
Oh, and he hand on the head, he knows that he's just killed one of his balls.
Terrible.
Because it's like a free shot now. You can just bump the, bump the,
you know, Mungrel might make this. He's done it to me a few times, I'll tell you.
He's done it to everyone a few times.
You know, he is very handy at these shots, right? Oh, he missed it. That's uncharacteristic. Mungrel's usually pretty good on those shots. Oh, that just didn't help.
Light should be off now.
Yeah. Oh, hold on. Is that right?
Yeah.
Oh, that good?
You press that and you'll see. That's the mute button, the orange one. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I'm back on board.
Okay, back to here.
So Jamie should have out.
Yeah. So he got another chance. Must have just touched the black, did he?
Yeah. Well, he bumped it. Remember on that shot?
Oh. Oh.
Yeah, he's got a. Trust the table and roll it in.
Yeah. A little bit of drag, you reckon?
Yeah, definitely. Oh, a little. Oh, jeez. He kind of underhit that one, you know?
Yeah.
He didn't follow through.
Yeah.
It worked.
Made the
draw. Yeah.
The last thing you want to do, really, you know what? The last thing you want to do is leave that over the pocket because you would have got one heck of a.
Oh, yeah. I'll tell you, they're not looking real sharp. It's early days, though.
2-0 to Jamie?
Yeah, 2-0 to Jamie, and Travis is kind of in a little bit of trouble, unless you can put this red in front of the yellow. Oh, okay. That was pretty good. But you know what? I think JT can take it from here.
What's JT on?
JT's on the yellows, I think. Unless he gave him two shots.
No, if he's on yellows, you can go out on yellows pretty easily from here.
Yeah.
Got the one over the pocket now.
But you know what? Maybe he gave him two shots. Really? I wasn't paying attention. Sorry, folks.
Okay. So we've just had confirmation. It is actually race to 11 on...
Mungrel's match.
On Mungrel's match. So I will be fixing that up now.
Okay, so, that didn't work out very good for. Oh, hold on.
No. What's he going to come off the rail and hit that red across?
Yeah.
Cover the left corner. Oh.
Well, I don't know what JT's waiting for. He could have went out.
I think. Look, I don't think he was happy going that yellow over the pocket. It was his safety net.
Yeah, but they're all sitting there. They're all wide open. Comes to a stage where you got to step out, you know? And he's got the talent to do it.
Good sound on both of us.
I don't know if that yellow goes down the rail on the left side, past that red. Unless you can pop this one in the bottom right and break out that red, but then, you know, you don't know where the white's going to end up, and you have to be pretty precise. Oh, and Jamie Stevens just got lucky. Oh.
Okay, I'm back. Just giving the tournament organizer a view to see what he thinks. It's doing pretty well for the streaming at the moment.
So it looks for Jason's game, it looks like that yellow on the left side.
It
looks like, because he's going for it, unless he's going to play the double.
I don't think it does.
He could have come around the rails with this, the bottom right, and kicked it, but they weren't sitting really good. Oh, you can't tell like that.
Yeah, I reckon it goes.
It must. But then what's he worried about? You know, he should take it.
Maybe, I don't know, getting onto the black as his last ball. Not too sure.
Well, if he just stuns over to that one on the left, but he's got topping on there. So it looks like it doesn't go, he's got to come up.
Well, can he pop into it off this yellow?
Well, Or
would you just leave yourself a double?
I'd just leave the double.
Or bank you.
Because you don't know where the white ball's going to go.
Okay, so
it goes. See, I don't understand that. You know, he could have made that one, you know, in the side, the first one in the side, and screwed into that one, and then then take that one he just parted in the bottom right, and, you know, it would have been easier. Because it's tight. This ball's tight. And he's got to come back for
the... Do you think he can generate the angle to get across for the black back in the
left
middle?
Yeah, but it's easy, but it's tight, hey? It's so critical that he makes this.
Just don't hit that left jaw first.
Yeah.
Oh, he's hit the left jaw.
See, he should have went the other way. You know, he should have took that one on the bottom right corner first.
So this is pretty elementary for Trav, right?
Yeah, it's all over.
Yeah.
Yeah. She's all over.
Oh, he's got the option of whichever one he wants to
go. I would take the one in the middle.
Yeah, because the natural angle of flat one
just
takes
stay
you back
right
for the black on your
just
last
screw
shot.
Screw off the rail, just like that.
Yep. JT,
but
will be
JT, you know, he didn't pick the right combination.
He'll be kicking himself over that.
It was a pretty easy out, really.
Yeah.
But, you know, nerves, I guess. Sometimes you don't see the balls, you know. Can't pick up the pattern, but JT should have had that. So it's 2-1 for Travis. And what do we got here with it's Jamie Stevens is on yellow.
Sorry,
if Mungo can get that, if he can see that bottom right red, he could be out.
I'm pretty sure he can from here.
Yeah,
but would you do it? I don't know if you'd do it.
Well, if he can get...
I think he's going the right shot.
Oh, that goes that way.
Yeah, that goes.
Yeah, I didn't realize that.
Oh.
Oh, Mungrel.
His only saving grace is he hasn't left a terribly easy shot.
Hmm. He could nick that one into the left side.
I think Mungrel was going to have a hard time getting back for that red anyway, in the middle. Even if he'd got these two.
Yeah.
Okay, back to the break on the other table. Wow. Like,
holy.
A yellow and two reds potted off the break. JT would be pretty happy with that, except he'd prefer to be on a ball.
Is this his first shot coming up?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, he's got, three reds and a yellow.
Yeah, so he's, well, no, he's
got
two reds.
Oh, two reds and a yellow, yeah.
But the problem is, I'd go, if that yellow goes past in the middle left, I'd go that.
Only
because...
all you got.
Yeah, you're going to play safe on your first red, you know.
Yeah.
If you go reds. I don't think you'll go reds. I think you'll go yellows.
Oh, I'd go yellow. I'd take that one by the black and into the side pocket and screw over for the one.
So he's looking at getting the white maybe down here or something. Oh, no. Don't kill that. That's
I think that one by the black might go on the side, you know.
is a kind of a containing shot, because the one on the yellow on the right rail is not easy straight down that rail.
Yeah, but a nice smooth shot, you know, with a little bit of left siding and you're right on the black. Oh, a little too far. Yeah. Otherwise,
he knows it too.
Yeah,
you know, it still cuts in the middle, I believe, that yellow. But you're kicking your other yellow across to the left rail.
That's right.
You'd
have to smack it.
Oh, really?
Or deep screw it to avoid it.
He's still kicking the yellow across to the where he doesn't want it to be on that left rail.
Yeah, but if he nails it and screws into that, like, you know, by that red.
Yeah, the bottom red, the one at the bottom of the table.
Yeah, and then he's got a shot.
Jeez, that's a hard screw into that ball.
Yeah, it's tough to see the angle, isn't it? You know?
But even...
He must not be able to do it.
No, he's...
Ooh, corner bank.
You reckon there's a hole there?
Yeah, big pocket. Beautiful. Oh, but he played too much safety, you know?
He didn't play safety, just the natural angle, I think.
I know, but you know, if you're really 100% sure you would make it, you wouldn't leave yourself like that.
Well, even if you'd missed
the
yellow.
Oh, look at Jamie Stevens here. He's going to... Yep, it's all over.
Another one for Jamie Stevens.
Yeah, 3-0.
Possibly.
Poor Mungrel, it could easily be... could easily have been 2-2, you know, because he gave 2 games away. Wow, what a nice shot. Did you see that? Mm. That is fantastic shot there, Travis Crawley. Beautiful control. I don't know. He's got no choice. He's got a... I don't know if you can see that one across to the side. Or he's got to try and nail that one down to the bottom left corner, the one he's sitting behind with the shooter. Sorry, folks. It's really hard to figure out the angles. I wonder how Mal's doing.
Mal and Brendan.
Yeah.
Not sure. See, the hard thing without using Poolstat, just so you're aware, it's quite difficult to know what everyone else's scores are because we don't have any screen captures for Poolstat, nor do we have any actual, any stats at all.
Yeah.
So it's all, you know, someone coming up and telling us what the score is. So I might actually, maybe in future years, ask for the money matches to be on Poolstat so that you can actually show everyone's scores.
Yeah, that would be the way to go.
Yeah, but I might be a bit tough to start putting money matches on Poolstat. I'd need to speak to...
Oh, nice.
Matty Harmon and...
Greg, bit stiff.
Greg Johncock.
That was a nice shot. You know, he broke that red out. But
yeah. Well, look at doubles. Still doubles.
Oh, middle. Yeah. Definitely. And he'd go 3 rails and be on that one.
Oh, ooh, your pace needs to be absolutely perfect, right? Yeah. Pocket weight almost.
But even if you're behind it, you still got the side in the far corner. You know, it depends on if he gets on the left-hand side
you
of it.
You know what I'd be doing? I'd be going around off 3 rails back for that one in the top.
Oh yeah, but you got to nail it.
I wouldn't even look at the one here in the middle of the table after this bank.
I think I'd go that one first for the corner. You know, I'd go for the one by his hand, second shot. Just like
pace.
This. Whoa!
Yeah,
beautiful.
No, that's good.
Beautiful.
That's very good. So that was him. So he could judge the pace really well.
Yeah, it's a bit sharp, but he should be able to. If he can just use straight topping with the little left and run 2 rails back around for the bottom one, it'd be sweet. And the black is sitting right there.
That's all right, I got it.
Yep. So Jamie, I don't know, man. He should have been out by now.
All the reds are out. Oh, hang on. So, potted a yellow.
Yeah, he's out now.
Yeah.
But Oh.
Look, it still goes.
I know, but
what's the white doing?
Well, he screwed into the right rail. I would have used
bottom left. He's going to put bottom left on this for sure.
No, I know, but I would have went two rails, but then you can't. It's hard to see the angles. Two rails, you stroke it, and it's just automatic position. Mm. And here's Jamie for 3-0. Jace.
Oh, he's got. He's going to go across the table. Oh.
Oh, that's not
I
very
thought he would
good.
Have gone for it into the middle or. Yeah, I thought he would have gone.
Well, he should have just screwed into the
look
left
at that.
Rail.
Such a good shot from JT there, and look at his angle on the black.
Yeah,
that's actually really good.
Yep. Now, if he can just steady his nerves.
So just bear with us while we switch between games as we commentate. It's just, you know, when we see interesting shots, then we start just commenting on it.
Jamie just won, but boy, he makes it hard.
Jamie's up 3-0.
Yeah.
Okay. Good.
He's doing it the hard way, though. I think. I don't know. But it's tough. Seeing the correct angle. And Mark went up for JT.
JT.
2-all.
2-all over there. Yeah, for sure.
And that was not an easy out.
No, it wasn't. He did well.
I don't know what all this shit is. But excuse me.
No swearing on the stream, please.
Little crumbs all over the tablecloth. I don't know where it comes from.
It's a black tablecloth. Yeah. Your dandruff.
Reminds me of my old vet. It had a 65 vet and it was black. And I'd wash it and chamois it. And as soon as I wiped the chamois over, dust was on there.
But yeah.
It's terrible. Same as this tablecloth.
Wow, that's a good break by Trav there.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
Been unlucky with the two clusters there.
Yeah. What would you do?
What would I do?
Yeah, I think I'd go red. Eh?
Oh, you
it's
know.
Either way, eh?
I think it has to go red because the yellow doesn't double back into the middle on the left rail.
Yeah.
And
And he might have a shot on the bottom right red into the left corner.
Maybe.
Either way, he's got a little bit of work to do. It's 50-50, eh?
Yeah. You reckon he'll play this fine to come off the top, then aside, not behind the yellow. Oh, okay, sorry, you nominated yellows.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, got it. Okay, smart move.
Yeah, definitely. See, I'm thinking black ball all the time because I don't...
But now JT can just glance off the left-hand side of that red and sit on the rail of the snooker room on the yellow and the top.
Yep.
You know, and make him play it something.
Oh, he's going to push that red down by the yellow. Play
that
the
red onto
three
yellow
ball combination,
red, yeah,
maybe.
Red onto
yeah,
yellow onto red.
Yeah.
Tough. You got to get it. You know, you can't afford to hit half ball on that yellow.
Yeah. But then you know the other. That yellow's tied up on the bottom right, too, you know, with the red, so. And it looks like Mungrel's having a go.
He needs to.
Yeah. He needs to break that cluster out.
Oh, this might jump in front of that.
Oh, that's not too bad.
You know, it's...
But he's got a break out here if I see the angle correctly. Either way.
It'll kiss the yellow down, actually, which is what he wants.
Yeah.
Pot this, plant that red onto yellow. No, okay.
Oh.
He did it differently. Yep. It still works.
Mm-hmm. And Mungrel just landed a little shy of position. Poor guy, he just can't get a roll on. Oh, another bank. I don't know. I guess... Mungo could take that one on the right bank to the side and possibly screw back for the bottom of the cluster yellow into the right-hand side, but you can't tell with these angles.
He's going to come off the red, do you reckon?
No, he's going to bank it, I think.
No, he's going to come off the red.
Oh, okay.
Sometimes it's, I know things.
Yeah, I know. It's just it's hard to tell. These, you can't see the angle. We're like about 5 meters away on the side, so we can't really have a look.
Hey, we've got a chat from Greg Laurie here saying, hi, Richard.
Hey, how you doing?
So
you're enjoying it, Greg.
You know Greg from the Masters, do you? Is that right? Is that where you know Greg from?
I think so, yep.
Yeah.
You know me, I have a good memory. It's just short. How's it going, Greg? Hope you're enjoying it. You know, Jamie and I could be twins, eh, with that haircut.
So just for everyone's information, we've got, you can see David Rothel and Jamie, Steve Jamison in the table top right of your screen. Don't know the score, unfortunately. And you've got Sean Ledson and Ron Farmer on the left table.
He just won.
Yeah, so that was just Jamo. Steve Jamison. Yeah, we don't know the score, unfortunately. Again, it's hard to tell without pool stat. Pool stat is what we really need.
Yeah. Can he hook it up for you?
No, not for the money matches. So I did ask, but maybe next year we might be able to, you know,
yeah, that's
explain
then
why.
Then we could just
oh, it's a lot of admin. I think it's some admin match. Work to put names in and all that sort of thing. And yeah, I think you've got to create a new actual.
Could you settle up for yourself?
No.
Too much?
No. So with an account, I believe.
Oh, look at Mungrel. He's in trouble. He needs a really good breakout shot here.
Do you reckon bottom right would go into those?
Yeah.
If you're wrong, you're in
but,
trouble.
But, you know, these pockets aren't that generous. You got to hit it beautiful.
That doesn't double, does it? That yellow? Because if that yellow doubles, I'd maybe double it.
I don't know. It's pretty tight in there, I think. He's got to break it out.
No, it doubles. No. For him to do that.
Oh, that one.
Yeah.
Okay. I thought you meant corner bank.
No.
Oh, and if anyone can make this, Mungrel can.
Oh, he's got two. He must have two to do that.
Ooh. No.
Oh, maybe
no.
Not. Oh, okay. Make it as tight as possible.
Now he's in trouble. Yeah, see you later.
Ooh, you reckon he's going to get snookered, do you?
Oh, yeah. Big time.
Oh, that's a good snooker, too.
Yeah. Tight. Now you could go double.
He's just going to touch that white and red.
Yeah. Oh, I keep thinking black ball. Because in black ball, you have to have a go. If you don't, it's a lost game. I keep forgetting. I love black ball.
He's calling you a yank.
Yeah, I'm forgetful. Sorry, Greg, but... You're forgetful, too. I'm from Canada, buddy. I'm no Yankee Doodle Dandy. We're cousins from across the pond, man.
Here we go. Look at
so
this.
Here's Jamie. It looks like he's going to win it. Oh, he missed. Can you believe it? Okay, Mungrel stroked his puppy in and get a game on the board. Oh, okay. Yeah, cool, man.
So we just brought up a picture of Greg Laurie there with his cat and bunny.
Beautiful. You're looking good, mate. Nice and comfy.
I think it's a bunny. Yeah. And
beautiful.
A dog there.
You're toasty warm, man. You got the best view in the house. Awesome. That is cool.
Yeah. Back to the match at hand.
Nice couch.
What's been happening?
Greg, I like the couch. Like the colour.
You know what? That was such a good shot by Mungrel.
Yeah. He'll stroke this in. Man, he's gotta.
Yeah.
Come on, Mungrel.
So you gotta put some...
Oh, man. You know, the last time you missed a shot like that was in 1988, I think. Wow. I can't believe he missed that so badly.
Yeah, he's 3-0 down, so...
Yeah, I know, but
a bit of
he's
pressure.
A fighter, mate. He never gives up, eh? Never count him out. Ooh. this looks pretty easy. Bottom left, top right, top left, stroke that one, last one on the rail into the right, and you're out. Yep. See, great minds think alike. He's doing just what I told him to do. Yep. I think it's going to be 4-0. And what's JT on? Is he on the yellows? No. Oh, he's in trouble again. Oh.
Jeez.
But he's hanging in there. It's 2-2.
Did you see Jamie Stevens just put that white on the side rail? That's
Oh yeah, yeah. That there. Was pretty ordinary. Eh?
Just have to really make sure of your angle
just
here.
Stroke it in. Doesn't matter where the white goes.
Yeah, that's right.
But yeah, you'd think he'd play a bit tidier than that, eh?
I would have thought so.
It's easy saying that when you're in the chair, though, eh?
No, exactly. I know. I agree.
Excuse me, folks, for coughing in your ear. I just asked Brendan Smith what the score was, and it's 3-3, Malachi McNeil and Brendan Smith, so it's a pretty tight match. Mal's been playing very well lately. And looks like a dry break for Mungrel, and they're all pretty open. Yellow looks like the ones. See, if a guy could get behind that yellow and play a four-ball combination on Travis's game, but good luck with that, because that yellow in the pocket's pretty smothered. The black is no good. That was a good shot by JT. Gives Travis something to think about. What would you do here, Kenny? Travis's game. Travis is yellow. Jay.
Oh. You know, maybe get the yellow closer to over the pocket.
Yeah.
Give him two.
Yeah, that's not a bad idea. But then he could just pound them out. Looks like he's going to do it. Yep. He's taking your advice, Kenny.
Yeah, I thought he would have.
Man, looks like Jamie may be out again.
Any changes to scores? Oh, Jamie got those. Jamie should be on 4, shouldn't he?
No, I think this is 4. Is this the fourth one?
Yeah, no, I'm pretty sure Jamie just got that and I didn't update the score, so
okay,
he'd be on 4.
Yeah.
And
oh, see that yellow by the black on Jamie's table? It looks like it doesn't even go, but I don't know. I wouldn't have went that way. But. Oh, yeah, I guess he's got to break it out because it's pretty tied up. Oh, come on, Mongrel. Let's have a win here, mate. You're not going to get a better chance than that. Well, you know, on Travis and Jason's game, it looks like it swung the other way, you know. Jason's got the upper hand here.
Yeah, don't leave the double across the table, though.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
But, and he didn't.
He didn't, no.
He might,
so I think Jason's...
It looks like he can still hit that.
Oh, yeah.
Heaps of left-hand side.
Yeah, geez, he might even... Might even make it.
Maybe, yeah. Look, it's going to be killing the black, though. I don't think you're going to be having the black on. Red should kick that black onto the rail.
He'll just tie that pocket up on the right-hand side, probably.
Yeah, see?
Bounce. Oh!
That's the problem. You're killing the black onto the side rail.
That was a nice shot. Bad luck on the shape. Those are not easy. Maybe he was just trying to lock that pocket up and it unfortunately fell in for him. And here's Mongrel. What's he going to do? Oh, Jesus. You know,
no.
He may be lucky.
No,
I'm
pretty sure he can see past that. If not, it'll just swerve it a touch. No, he can see past it. Easy.
Yeah. Jeez, I haven't seen Mongrel play this bad for ages. Ever, for that matter.
Ooh, still all right.
Mm-hmm. Poor Mongrel, he can't cut a break, eh?
So Greg Laurie says he's there right now. So he says, I know, and I'm there right now. To you.
Oh.
So where'd you say in overseas? You said something to him about where he was, where you were. And he says, I know, I'm there right now.
Oh.
Anyway, let's fix so
it looks so like it's 5-0.
Trav got that one, so Trav's up 3-2 and Jamie's up 5-0. Okay. Let's fix it.
How did Travis get that? I was looking at Greg's chat. And I missed it. It looked like JT had a good
We're both looking at Greg's
good
chat.
Shot at it, but I can't believe Mongrel's 5 down, really.
Yeah.
I think he's given 3 games away at least. Oh, nice break.
Ball straight in the pocket. No jaws, no nothing. Just straight in.
Ooh, those yellows look pretty tidy, except for the one on the left. But he hasn't got an opener, so he's got to go red. So. And even that's not very nice. And what about JT here? We got, what, yellow? A yellow down? Well, JT's got a chance here, right? If he can get on that yellow on the bottom rail to get behind that yellow on the right hand side for the side pocket, but then roll up the one on the left side, take that yellow by the red on the left side on the bottom into the corner, and he's out. If you get my drift, guys, we need pointers. Oh, that wasn't very... Oh, JT, what are you doing, mate? JT just gave 2 shots away and went in off. And Mongrel is going to try and lock that pocket up. He just seems to always... Oh, no, he's going to take it. He just seems to be just off balance. You know, like, just... You know, he's got clusters to deal with. Mm. And, you know, he just seems not be able to get a break. You know? This is such a hard out. He's got to make me make a ball and play a safe... lock up a pocket. preferably that bottom left pocket. And that's what he did. That's a nice shot. Now should just stroke this in if he can lock up that bottom left pocket. But I don't know if it goes by that yellow in the middle left. Oh, nice. But Jesus, it just keeps getting harder and harder. I don't think he can make that one down the rail. No.
So just for your information as well, if you want to do any replays, let me know. We can do some replays on this.
Jamie's texting. Jamie Stevens is texting his win.
I'm up 5-0. Yeah.
Looks like I'm going to win. Ooh. See, if that black goes past that red into the left pocket, you know Jamie's out.
Yeah, I don't think it does. I honestly
Well, it could go in the side pocket on the right. You know, he could be out here, man. Couple of nice positional shots and he's done. Jason's doing pretty good. He's hanging in there. 3-2. He's holding his own. Mm-hmm. One nice shot here. One good positional shot and Travis is out. Ooh, I don't like that. That wasn't very nice. Why didn't he just go off the back cushion?
He's comfortable playing the...
he's got two shots. Ooh, sorry,
you know what?
Folks.
He's annoyed at himself. He's on the wrong side of that red.
That's right, yeah. Now he's got to...
That's why he knocked the table.
Either stroke it ahead with a lot of left-hand siding and come off that side cushion or screw back and then make a long red in the bottom top left. See which way he goes. Oh, might screw around the angles. Looks like he might. Yep. It's a bit indecisive. You can go three ways, but it's whatever you feel comfortable with. Yeah. Yeah, I could just nail it in the side. And a lot of bottom.
Yeah.
Check siding here.
So we've got a couple more. Okay, so Greg Laurie says no. He's
oh, look at this. Oh, what a nice shot. A little fierce. A little fierce, right?
He's Chinese.
Yeah, but you know he'll be out. Yeah. That was a nice shot. Man, he got some power on that thing. You know, that was a nice shot.
So, Greg says he's on the couch still. That's what he said, where he was.
I'm in the chair too, Greg. I'm in the chair. You're on the couch. I'm in the chair.
And when we asked
Oh, look at this.
When we asked about how Travis potted that black and come back and said Travis doubled the black. So he must have face cut doubled the black.
Oh, okay.
Middle.
Yeah. Jeez, that was a beautiful shot he made.
You know. So Travis is up 4-2.
Two and rails, man.
Jamie must think he can swerve this.
Jamie's got the peephole out.
Okay, I'll fix up Travis' score, 4-2.
Yeah, he's going for the swerve, I think.
He should be able to get it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Wow.
6-0. I think he's done.
It's going to make it tough.
He needs to win a cluster of games, preferably about 5 in a row. And he's capable of doing it, you know. It's just not his night, I guess. He's not playing very good. You know, he's way better than what he's showing, that mongrel. You know?
So we have 39 people watching, which is really good.
Hello, guys. Who's all watching? Oh, Anne, hi, Anne.
Doesn't say who's watching, but Anne and Greg are the only ones that have commented.
Anne and Greg, you're the only ones that have the nerve to put your name in there. So it looks like, Mungrel made a red, but I don't know. I take that one in, that red, the top red of the cluster three, and try and break into those two.
Mungrel's got a lot of work to do, doesn't he?
Yeah, but I guess he hasn't got the angle. I don't know. I would have tried to open those up first, but then what do I know? And it looks like Travis and Jason are taking a break. Okay, he's got to play. Oh, see, he's got to break those two reds out by the black, eh? Unless he can sneak behind them and take it in the side and open that one up for the other side. This has got to be perfection here in Mungrel. Whoa, 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 whoa. It looks kind of straight for the kiss, doesn't it? Kenny's commentating with me. He's not even looking at the screen.
Kenny's just trying to get some, get the... information correct on the internet.
Oh, okay.
Making sure that the want to get this thumbnail changed so it actually is the King's Cup thumbnail. See, not the
Mungrel's got that red, but it's straight in.
What happened?
Might be able to cheat the pocket.
They're having a bit of a break on that one.
Yeah,
they?
Yeah,
yeah. Oh, I don't know. What? Okay, so that must go. Right?
Must go. Yeah.
But almost doesn't look like it does.
Doesn't look like it from here. It doesn't look like, because that yellow's in the road too.
Yeah, but he just sit in front of the yellow.
Unless he's got a combination in the side. I don't know, man. He's not playing very well. He had a chance to break it out early, but he didn't do it. He went downstairs instead, or up the top, I should say. But I thought he could have broke it out right off the get-go. Oh, kiss another one goodbye, I think. Jamie's pretty conservative, though. I don't know. And he's that cluster on the left side, you know, if he takes that one that's furthest down and bumps into it, the one that's on the rail, he's got that one on the bottom right-hand corner to make. That's his... Oh, did he... really? But... it's two shot, so yeah, that was a good shot. And Travis is about to break on the left table. Looks like a dry break, is it? No, red down. Looks like he's got to go yellow, though. Poor Mungrel. He just can't get a break. No. Well, he may have... Oh, I don't know. If he gets down low, he can take that yellow by the red on the top of the table. But he's got that cluster on the side, those two yellows on the left side.
Okay, so we've got a couple more people commentating. Ant Barrett says, you should have gone with Ajeza, Lucky. And
Ian Chungy, how you doing, mate? How you doing?
That's not my Canadian Queensland friend on the mic, is it?
It hey, sure Richard. Is, mate. How you doing, Ian?
He's going, ah.
My buddy Ian, man, we go back a long ways. Haven't seen him in ages. But Tasmania, I think, was the last time I saw him. But, yeah, we used to play a lot together.
Okay.
Yeah, Dynamite player. beautiful family. Mm. And he's been on the road a lot too lately. I've seen on Facebook, traveling all over the world. You lucky dog. You know, Ian, I think maybe you should adopt me and take me with you on your trips. So.
That was a nice shot that Jamie Stevens just played to break those yellows.
Oh, okay.
Oh, that's an uncharacteristic miss.
Yeah, but poor JT, he hasn't got much to work with.
No.
And looks like Jamie is going to make the move.
Yeah.
Just one hard shot down the rail, and that's it.
Well, you get the middle now.
Get the middle, and then that one on the left down to the bottom left corner.
Oh, that's a nice shot. Oh, no. Pot of yellow at the same time. Hang on. Oh. Maybe I missed something.
Off the cush, off the yellow for JT.
For some reason, I thought he potted a yellow in the middle right, and he's
oh, nice. That was the winning shot for Jamie, it looks like. Could have come out a little further, but, you know, should be able to handle this.
Sorry, JT is on yellows, not reds.
Oh, JT's looking
good for the
out. Yeah,
I like JT's position here. Yeah.
Take that one on the right side pocket last and just drift down for the black.
Yeah.
I'd be screwing over for the left corner.
Yeah, he'll do that.
Yeah. Ooh. Oh.
That's right. Runs between the red and black on Jamie's
team. Yeah.
And just put the white right up the top again.
Yeah.
Doesn't really matter where you put it.
It's a bit untidy, but...
Yeah. Oh.
Oh, God.
That's not what I expected.
Yeah,
I think you know what?
He stroked down on the ball.
I think he could see through that. There's a hole there.
I don't know, man. Swerve it.
No, you don't need to. Look, I reckon he can hit the side of that yellow.
I don't know.
Yeah.
If it's fine, he might overcut it. I'd just put a little juice there.
So JT's leaving that yellow to last.
I'd swerve it about an inch.
Oh, no. He's getting rid of it now. Oh, yeah, fair enough.
Oh.
Yeah, it's all right. That's good.
Come on, Mongrel. One nice long pot. Bottom left. Come off that cushion and away you go, buddy. Come on, mate. You stroke these in, no problem.
He's got a lot of pressure on him. Cause
that's better. That's a nice shot.
That's the Mongrel we know.
Yeah, he's hitting them nice. When he's fluid and on a roll, he is deadly. Oh, nice shot, JT.
Yeah, JT should be good here.
Yeah, definitely.
Oh, way on the rail.
And he's like you, Kenny. He likes to shoot off the rail.
That's it. I do.
But you know what? It doesn't matter where they are. If Mongrel's hitting them good, it's all over. Come on, man.
6-1.
Beautiful.
And JT's about to go fourth, get an extra one?
Yep, fourth.
Okay, 6-1,
whoa,
4-3.
Whoa, baby.
That's right.
Anyway, I'm going to... go for a smoke. Mm. Do you want a drink or anything?
No, I'm all good, thanks.
Okay, cool. Okay, time for me to go for a smoke, guys. Ian, I hope you're still on.
Oh, was it open table? Okay, yeah. So he potted one of each, so he then got to choose what he was on.
Yeah. Anyway, be back in 5.
Well, basically got to keep playing, I guess you could say. Putting whatever he wants after that. Okay, so Richard's off, and it's just me left. Yeah. See how Jamie's break is. Big break, nothing down. Doing well. We've got 43 people watching, or 42 people watching now, which is good. So the more people watching, the better. I'd like to get some exposure to this. Get some King's Cup action going on. So dedicated to Barry King, the late Baz, and Alicia. And proudly sponsored by ASD Optical and a number of other minor sponsors have come on board. We have Poolstat doing a really good job. We're looking forward to that occurring Sunday and Monday. Some the best inventions I've seen, Poolstat. Very, very good. Use it for most of our competitions now. Wouldn't go back. Okay, let's have a look at Mungrel's table over here. Just with the cluster of red and yellow on the left, that'd be his only issue. I don't even think there's a plant that would kick that red over the pocket. While he's taking a bit of a break, while he wants to work out what he's going to do, we'll go and have a look at Trav's. The only issue I can see with Trav's match here is the black. You know, you pop that black open and it's all right, but you don't pop it open. Mungrel did well, put his red over the pocket. So again, apologies for switching between frames for our commentating, but last thing we want is a lull. just keep looking at each shot as they're happening. Oh, Trav just wants to set it up. Don't know about that. Force him to play that yellow and you're in trouble, and Trav's in trouble if he's only got to play the one over the pocket. Yeah, I think JT's playing the right ball. Soft one, just leaving the one over the corner pocket. Or not. Okay. Oh, Trav didn't want to be kissing that one. He's left all the reds open now. It's just unlucky. Yeah, half killed his yellow ball and opened up the red across to the bottom left. Just unlucky. Looking at JT's game here, if it was me, I'd just be leaving that red below the black till last. Just get rid of the other five up the middle, above the black, and you should be fine. Just get position the one on the top rail as soon as possible. Maybe off the one in the middle. Yeah. Cool. I wonder if this red's straight enough in the top right to leave him on the top rail. Might be. If not, he's got to play the one over the middle right with bottom left. Yeah, okay. It's still on. It's actually quite good. Pretty elementary now if he gets the right pace. Yeah, I think more important than anything was actually had to pot that ball. He probably just hit it a bit harder than normal to do that. Make sure it went in. Oh, can he hold it? No. Beautiful shot. Beautiful shot. Just the right angle to float down for the other end. Oh, and you know what? JT will be very unhappy with that. One, he didn't bring it, put enough back bottom spin on, and two, he hit the wrong angle. Oh, you know what? Didn't want that, but it's all right. You just pop that black in the same pocket. Yeah, JT won't be happy at all with that. Trav goes up 5-3. Back on the other table, it looks like Jamie's should run out on these. Oh, hang on. That's a bit unlucky. He'll probably just play the plant now. I've turned it off, so you need to turn it back on. Richard's back on the commentary.
Yep, am I on? Yes, I am. I'm on the ball. What did I miss? Who won that last game with Travis and JT?
JT should have won. You know, he really should have. He just let it get away.
And Mungrel's on red here?
Munger's on reds, on what he's going to do. Yeah.
Did he play a shot and put himself in that position? Or did Jamie put him there?
Oh, I think his red was in a hard position in the bottom left, near the bottom left corner.
Yeah. Oh!
Hang on, did he just move that with his hand?
Yeah.
He's got two?
Yeah.
Okay, I didn't realize that.
You got to be careful with this.
Oh.
Don't go in, baby.
Oof, didn't need a rail. He's going to be really, really upset about that. Going in's fine if with two shots.
Well,
he gave it away because he didn't hit a rail.
Oh, yeah. I was watching the other game. Oh my God, he just can't get a break, Mungrel. You know.
Jamie, I just want to get up for that yellow back inside the red.
Yeah.
And he did.
That's perfect. Any angle would have done. Looks like it's pretty open. Oh, maybe not. Uh-oh. Are we back? Yeah, we're back.
Yeah, just lost it. Zero.
It was Asia cutting us off.
None of that conspiracy theory on the stream, please.
Did you see that little kiss off there? Rail, red, and in goes the yellow. Oh, God, that's why I don't like two shot, right? You know? If it was black ball, you'd have to stroke that in. You know, Jesus, 7-1, man.
7-1, is it?
Yeah.
I'll fix that up.
And JT's on the yellows. They don't look too bad. Unless there's one by, nope. Oh, that's not too bad. If he makes this combination, you know, he's out. Black's kind of tough.
Still 5-3, I believe, Travis.
Yeah, if JT can make this combination, you know, he's got a good chance to get out. Oh, and he didn't cover. Yeah, they're pretty much.
Okay, I'm now off mute. So, yeah, like I said, if he misses it, he's in trouble. Yeah. And he missed it. And left a hole in that bottom left, too.
That's right, yeah. A little bit of moving around, but Travis probably should be able to get out from here because those two reds behind the black.
That's right.
Looks like that one can go in the left corner. Ooh, that looks ugly, eh? Look at that one, Jamie's table.
Yeah, well, just give me a second while I fix up these screens. Three, 1, 2. Apply. And make this my main one.
Oh, I'm off.
No, you will be for a second. Just bear with me.
Yep.
And
the last time I checked, Mal McNeil and Brendan Smith were 5-all.
There we are.
Pretty tight match.
Okay, so we've got 48 people watching now, which is really good.
Side, corner, side.
Oh, yeah.
And it's all over. How you going?
Yeah. Come on, Mongol. Let's put a match in, hey? It's actually good now. It's a race to 11 rather than a race.
Oh,
that's geez. I'm very, very glad that didn't happen.
Yeah, but look at that red that he's looking at now.
Yeah, red goes inside the yellow on the bottom left.
Yeah, well, he can afford to do because that black's pretty miserable.
He might pop into it now.
Oh, look at this. Oh.
I don't know if he wanted to pop that.
Jesus.
Actually, yeah. I actually probably did want to pop that because no. Jamie could have probably ran out from where he was.
Well, he's... Oh.
No. Oh he's popped it out. God. He's popped it out. It's all right.
Yeah, but Jamie's got a lot of balls to break that black out, well, not you know, to work
the one
with.
The ones he needed, the red's now in the way to break... To come off that black?
I don't know. Those three yellows on the left-hand side, if he takes that one in the middle
yeah,
and
but
swings
look at
it around.
So he's playing one of the ones now. I don't think he's...
I'd take the one in the middle first and just swing it around two rails with a lot of bottom left because you got that one sitting over the side there.
Yeah, look, I would be getting rid of those early as well.
Yeah, I wouldn't be hanging around. See, he's got a bad angle. He could have done it, I think, right off the bat. But then it's hard to see, you know? Mm. See, that's no good. Well, this might be not bad. But it's a bit too steep of an angle, maybe. It's going to have to hit it with a lot of bottom. Oh, covering. Wow, did you see it? Oh, you missed a dynamite shot from Jamie. Oh. Yeah, I think Jamie should have broke it out right off the bat, but now it's going to be a dogfight for 15 minutes. Oh, if that yellow goes by the black on Jamie's table, that was a nice little breakout. Well, he got out of there nice.
Okay, I'm back. Oh, just in time for Jamie to go
8-1. Wow.
Mongrel will be going.
Mongrel is playing probably at about 20% of his game, and maybe even less. He is way, way better than what you're seeing, folks.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Definitely.
It's no fun being in that situation, you know?
Oh.
No, he's covering. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because he's got that. That red and yellow on the right-hand bottom is messing him up.
Well, Trav's just going to develop his balls while there's a dead red there.
Yeah. I'd slice it down the rail with a lot of left and kick that yellow on top.
He'll hit the top. He'll hit that yellow. Oh, but not with a hole there.
So see, I'm thinking black ball. And I play really aggressively. Eh? Yeah. You know, I don't like to fool around. Yeah, I would have sliced that one down the rail with left and then kicked that yellow out. Because that cluster down in the bottom right. See, Atali, you take care, eh? Take care.
It's a good shot. Oh, he didn't want that in. Oh, and he didn't want that sitting on the yellow like
that. But you know what? If he can get down table and take that bottom right... red.
Yeah, it'll break into those two. Yeah.
So, you know, if he plays a nice positional shot here.
What do you reckon? So, screw straight back? Or
I would try and, come off. Straight back, yeah. But and land up around where the black is, you know? Maybe a little bit deeper.
A bit lower, yeah.
Yeah.
I reckon he'll just put the black, red further over the... No. That's actually a really good shot.
Nice kiss. Yep. Beautiful. Now all he's got to do is...
How much do you want to pop into this?
Well, you want to hit it full in the face and leave it maybe right there and then take that one on the left side and come around. See what he does.
Ooh, that works. It looks like it's still on.
That's a good shot. Yep. Very nice. And Mungrel's in trouble again. Those yellow is in front of that red there. What's he going to do? Plug or? Ooh. Oh, jeez.
Well, he's under a lot of pressure, 8-1 down.
Yeah.
To 11.
Yeah. But, no, you know, if he's playing me, that red would be right over the hole, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, he couldn't see it.
But he's left a dead straight yellow one.
Yeah. There. Wow, I can't believe it.
He's, to be honest,
I thought he could see it. Oh, he left. Did he leave a gap for Mungrel?
Jamie.
Yeah. Looks like that red might go by him. One nice shot here, Mungrel.
It's a good shot. Oh,
when was the last time you seen him miss one of those? Poor guy.
I don't let him hear you say that.
I feel for him, eh? He's not playing 10% of his game, man. If he was on, he'd be out. I think that was the easiest 400 that Jamie ever made.
He wants that red out. Jamie will come half ball off the red, do you reckon? Although, you know what? I don't think he will. And the reason I say that is you're your moving balls that you don't.
Well, I would just cut it in the side and swing around for that red by the black.
Exactly.
He's on yellow. Excuse me.
Your move balls that you don't need to move.
That's right. Yeah. I thought he was on the reds. Yeah, this is all right. Because he can play a combination on one of those yellows side by side there. Now we get to look at his physique. Oh, Jamie, Jamie.
I did not expect that.
No.
Wow, Trav's just on fire.
Yeah, yeah. He may have maybe a little bit straight. If he's got a little angle, it's nice. But that's a hard shot down the rail. These pockets are tight. Okay, Mongrel, open that one up.
Be a bit worried about that one. I'd almost go well, now. Yeah, that's.
Yeah, that's the one. And then, and.
Hang on. Was
what
there
was
a force,
that?
Force field. It was a force field. It just stopped.
Yeah, I know. Did it hit his tip? No. We gotta rewind that one, man. What the hell was that?
On that?
That was brutal, mate.
Let's have a look at the replay, hey?
Yeah. That was unbelievable, man. It stopped on a dime.
Yeah. See if I can get this replay going.
Watch this cue ball at Mongrel. He nails it, and it just skids and stops dead.
Okay, let's have a look at it now.
Yeah.
This is the shot.
Wow. Wow. You don't see that very often. That was unbelievable.
Yeah. Anyway, let's go back to the twin tables again.
Wow, I can't believe that shot. One easy shot here and mark up another one for Jamie. Yep. Screw back, same pocket. Black in the same pocket.
Sorry, guys. There we go. We're back on.
Okay.
Now. Apologies for that.
Oh, this one isn't.
Sorry, it's just a preview. Fix it up. Should be back very shortly.
It's freeze frame, eh?
Yeah. It wow. Does that now and then.
You've played around too much, mate. So what's happening?
Hold on.
Is it just our monitor?
Nah, it's... You should be able to watch that now while I fix this up.
Okay, so...
Okay, we're back to normal now.
Yeah, and you got to add one for Jamie, I think.
Yeah. Yeah.
And
Jamie or Trav?
Both of them. Because this is a fresh game.
Jamie went up to 9 and Trav's gone up to 6?
Yeah.
Okay, done. Let's fix that then. He's a 9, is he?
Oh, see, look at that. Look at Mongrel missed that by a mile. He never misses those. Oh, Travis just potted a yellow. Nothing looks easy for a starter. Yellow in the top left, red in the top right, and that's about it, I think.
Yeah. So just bear with me, guys. I'm just I don't use replay too much, so got to get it right and without wasting all the time. Oh, look at that.
Jamie
red.
Just yeah. dogged the red. But I'll tell you what, you know what? It was worth it to look at that
it
shot.
Was.
Oh, that was amazing. I'm going to see if I can do that at home.
Oh,
that's a nice shot. That's a nice shot.
Yeah, yeah, that looks good.
9-1 for Jamie and 6-3 for Travis. Yeah.
JT had his chances.
Hey, who won with Brendan and Mel? What was the score? Wow. Because it was 5-all.
What was the pot? What was the pot? Pot? Total? Okay.
Wow.
Yeah, so just letting everyone know, Brendan got up 8-5 over Mal, Maliki, with a pot of 500.
Yeah, so and they were neck and neck, 5-all. So,
oh, wow.
Yeah,
so Brendan
yeah.
came back with 3 in a row.
That's right.
Look, I was practicing with Brendan last night, and he was on fire. He was really playing well.
Well, you know, Mal was over at my place when we were playing, and my God, that guy, he pots them from anywhere, you know?
I know.
You know, they're both good players, mate.
Okay, just back to the table, and look at this. Jamie's got another shot on the red.
Yeah, it's not easy, though.
He wasn't going to miss that one. Oh, he dropped it short.
Yeah.
Way short.
Yep. And look at Travis. He's looking for... Oh,
he's going to come off the yellow, half ball off the yellow. No, he's not. Why wouldn't he just pop the red over the top corner?
I don't know. Bad luck, bud. It was 5-all.
I mean, yeah. I'm sure I'd give it away.
Did you?
Yeah. Miss pot section, never ever miss.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I was just saying to Kenny, when you're over at my place, you're hitting them like God. You know?
Yeah, we're just having a chat to Mal on the in the background here.
We'll be him on the scotch.
Yeah.
I was playing with Brendan last night, practicing with him, and he was on fire. Yeah, he was playing really well. Mm, yeah.
Well, it was close. Look at poor Mungrel, 9-1. Mungrel, I think he's playing about 10% of his game, and he just can't get a break.
Oh,
oh.
No.
Yeah, Mungrel's, he's a world champion, mate. You know, he... You know?
Yeah, but he's
I've never seen
champion
him.
Masters playing against Jamie Stevens, though. Jamie
I
Stevens
know, but
yeah.
he really, I mean, if the guy's game is just not on tonight, you know, if he was loose and playing his game, it would be a lot tighter, trust me. He gave, what, the first 3 or 4 games away, literally.
Jamie's going to go for a 3-ball plan here, but Jesus, like that's a less than 90-degree cut. And then the red won't...
Oh, he's going to... No, he's going to kiss that.
But the red won't even be favourable after if you do get the plant.
You're better off kissing...
The yellow will be in front of it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I just didn't like it.
No, I thought... I would have kissed off the red. You know, punched it over to the right-hand side and used the white for the combination, but it's hard to see the angle, you know? It really is.
I don't think this red's on in the bottom left corner for Jamie.
If it is, it's bloody tight.
Yeah. It's almost worth doubling that. Does that double? I don't even think that red doubles back because the yellow's in
no,
there.
No. And you're losing the white, eh? And that bottom right is...
No, actually, I don't think the yellow's in the way.
Well, yeah, but that bottom...
Doubling the red across the table back into the right middle. My apologies.
It was wide open,
yeah,
man.
And the double's on.
Yeah.
Or he wouldn't have played that.
That's right. But the way he was looking at it, looked like it was really tight. Oh,
he's feeling sorry.
Yeah.
Mungrel now. Mungrel shouldn't lose from here.
No, he shouldn't. No. He's just got to nudge those
Travis,
two yellows.
Travis on the black to go possibly 7-3 up. Travis
wow.
actually playing really well. I like his style at the moment.
Oh, he's a good player. Smooth,
very solid.
Silk. Yep. Knows all the ropes.
Good on JT for going up against him.
Yep, yep.
Travis a very
JT,
hard nut to crack.
JT's not afraid to step out.
No, that's good to see. That's what we need. He people pitting themselves against interstate players.
Look at this. He just can't get a break, the poor guy, you know? Jesus.
Wow.
That's unbelievable.
Trav missed by a massive way. Oh, no. Mungo wouldn't have been happy if that had gone in.
Wow. Poor Mungo, eh?
Well, he's got a chance.
Yeah.
Oh, at least he hit a rail this time.
Up and down, cutter in.
Yeah. Hey, that's what I'd do against you, and I'd get it too.
That's what I do against you, and I get it too.
Yeah, whatever.
I got to brag. I had a shot like that. It was a bit closer to the hole, and on a snooker table, and I went up and down, made the red. It was 96. Got on the black and ran the tables. 135 or 136.
That was in your heyday, was it?
Yeah, that was in my heyday back in the day, right?
When you could see the other end of the snooker.
Yeah, that was against Alex Christie. He couldn't believe it. Alex was a sweetie. I loved that guy. We used to have a lot of good matches.
Jamie.
Do you remember Alex?
No.
No. The Scotchman. Down to Southern Cross.
Yeah, I remember that, Alex.
Yeah, he was a good guy.
Jamie's about to possibly go 10-1 up. Like, yep. He's just... Mungrel just gave him a chance. What's going on?
Well, he's Mungrel is not playing very well.
Not at all.
Trust me. So JT's on the reds. And, if he can pop something in, he's a chance. Oh,
JT, what are you...
Well, that's all right. Knife that yellow close to the blue spot and come off that side cushion, make that red down the rail on the bottom, and he's out, you know?
He'll go to the middle pocket now with a lot of bottom on it, right?
I wouldn't use bottom. I'd just use a little bit of just a subtle right-hand side. So
yeah?
Yeah, so it slides down. But you know, it depends on the angle, eh? Yeah, well, like that.
Well, that's bottom. That was bottom.
Well, it was spinning left to right, so he put a little bit of right hand on there.
Huh. You know? Yeah.
So if he makes this and gets on something, he's out.
Yeah. He can't afford to miss it, so he'll just play it. Yeah, pocket weight. A bit harder than pocket weight.
I'd go that one on the left side, take that one in the corner that he's looking at now. I wouldn't take the red on the right-hand side. I'd go left-hand side first, stun across to the blue spot. Different strokes. I guess because I'm left-handed.
Good. Just want to see if I can hear the music. Yeah. Last thing I want is to have music blaring on the stream.
It's good music. It's good music, though.
Yeah. Might be good music. I just don't want to hear it.
See, I don't know. What would
JT, he's got a good chance if he gets the right angle. Well, Jamie, Steve Jamison's out of here, so just see how he went against the Roth. I'm just going to check now.
Steve, how'd you go? What was the score? Okay. 8-4.
Okay,
very well done, mate. Just take care.
Just letting you guys know, Steve Jamison and David Rothel's match. Jamo got up 8-4 in his match, and he's now off to get some sleep for tomorrow.
And David Rothel is a really, really hard player to beat.
Oh,
this guy's deadly.
Very hard.
Atta go, Jace.
Oh.
It's 6-4.
6-4?
Yep.
Good,
Jason
good
pulled one out of the hat.
Yes, definitely. Needed it with a race to eight.
And here goes Jamie. He's got one hard red, but it looks like it'll be a tight snooker coming up.
Well, even if it's a tight red, you've still got the yellow that's...
I know.
Well.
Make this...
So just go the out, right? You know.
But that red down the rail.
What the heck was that?
That was a shocker.
Yeah, I think he knows it too. I saw the smile on his
face. Do you think that yellow will cut in the side?
He's having a good grin, a good laugh there.
It does.
He's seen it.
Bank. See, that's what I mean. You know, mongrels like that. He just steps up to the plate and smokes it in, right?
Oh, he has to come off the rail.
Oh, what?
No, well, he had to come off the rail.
It looked like it was on.
It did look like it was on. I could do a replay, but...
No, don't.
Nah. It takes too long to get
back
onto
the... We
don't
want no replays here.
So, Colin saying it was stun more than screw.
Yeah, it was sort of in between, you know. It was kind of in between, you know.
I was expecting a bit more bottom, but he played it the right way.
So I like sometimes just below center, you know, with a little bit of right, so it checks off that rail.
I just thought it was a finer shot than that, but it wasn't.
Yeah. Oh, look at this.
He's leaving him on it.
Feeling mercy, I guess. Yeah. Come on, Mungo. Come on, baby.
Jamie Stevens in the background flexing his muscles.
Whoa.
Yeah, that's not bad now.
See how fluid he is, eh?
Yeah, when he's... Yeah, when
oh, Jesus, it wiped its feet before it went in.
Well, he got it, though.
Yeah. Nine more.
Wow, I haven't clicked on this button at all. This is the second time I've clicked on this button in a while.
What button is that?
To increase Mungrel's score.
Oh. You're getting the callus from hitting Jamie's, though, eh? Okay, JT's looking not too shabby.
JT. Come on, mate. They're all on.
Yep.
You know what to do.
He could do it either way. Side, corner, corner, side.
I think, you know what? I don't know what he'd do here.
Well,
heaps of bottom left, or would you?
You can just come out for that one by the red.
Yeah, he will.
And by the black.
Yeah,
just
that's
stroke
that's
that in
doing.
And away you go. Could have been a little
bit
further.
Yeah, dropped a bit short.
Yeah. But still, even if he just sort of rolls it in with, you know, a little bit of bottom and comes off that red, depends on the angle.
Oh, great shot.
Beautiful. Nice shot.
Can he get past that red, do you think? I think it does.
Oh, easy.
Yeah.
Easy.
Just don't hit it hard.
Drive a truck through there, mate. You just got to control the white.
Yeah.
Is he going to nail it and come off the side cushion,
right,
or just soft screw?
There's a touch of right-hand side, top run through.
Yeah. Oh, Jason, what are you doing, mate?
I don't understand why he didn't run through it with off two rails.
It looked like you kind of snatched at it, you know what I mean? He didn't follow through.
It was on the black, but, just...
Yeah, but that's not an easy shot either, you know?
I think he's going to get snookered here, to be honest.
Mungrel just about made both of them.
Oh, he gave him two, did he? Yeah.
It's a hard day at the office for Mungrel. Like Neil Whitbread would say, I'm feeling for you. I'm feeling for you.
How's Trev going to play safe on this?
Well, he'll make a ball and then...
And then play safe.
Yeah.
Really, because there's no...
No, unless he can just bounce that red off that cushion and the white
off
leave
the side
it.
Rail.
Yeah, just as close to the rail as you can. But
put two reds in front of that yellow.
Yeah, well, you're blocking off the the cushion shot, you know.
Yeah, that's what he's doing.
Yeah. Oh,
yeah,
could
no,
be
he's
on.
All right.
Yeah.
He's all right. No.
Well, maybe, you know, if you use a lot of left-hand side, top left-hand.
You got to swerve past the red before it even...
I know, but if you can make it go through, follow through more with top left-hand, like a nice slow,
Look, we probably can't even see the angle. Yeah. It's probably...
You got to hit it harder than that.
No, look, I didn't even think he could do that.
I would have went for the pot, but then, it's black ball. I'm always thinking black ball, you know.
I reckon he's going to snooker again.
So
I think he has to.
I haven't been watching Jamie. Is he on reds? No, he's on yellow.
He's on reds, I think.
Well, I'll tell you what. If he makes this, it's over, mate.
It's over, yeah.
Nice and smooth. Stroker in there, mate. Just like that. But overcut it.
No, he did. He overcut it. It wasn't rolling down the rail.
That's right. Should have been hugging that rail. But Mungrel still has a lot of work to do. But it, you know what? If he gets that yellow just behind the black, that's the wrong shot,
yeah,
I think.
Playing the top right.
That's right, to break that one out.
Well, he's got a nice snooker. But
yeah. But, you know, he could have nailed that one in the corner, broke that one out in the side, and used that middle one, you know, the right-hand side.
He's still got a yellow and a black together, so he probably did the right thing to try
and get
two.
No, but if you used that one there, right,
yeah.
Just, you know, at...
near the middle right.
At 1 o'clock by the black, and just stroke it down, follow through, he was out. Oh, easily said, though.
Wow.
I know Ian could do it. If Ian Changi was playing, he'd do it. He's still with us, Ian, or what?
Oh, there you go. So who's the Yank? You're being called the Yank. He's doing some good analysis, by the way. Perhaps he'll mention inside and outside English to educate the Kangaroos.
I'll tell you what, you Kangaroos are pretty smart. I mean, look at Neil Robertson, man. You know, that guy is so good.
I think Colin Colenso is English, British.
Oh, yeah?
Not too sure. They talk a lot of English over there, don't they?
Yeah.
Inside, outside, check side, running side.
Well, in Canada, we used to go, you know, 12 o'clock, 6 o'clock, 2, you know, 1, 2, 3. To be more specific, but, you know, it's too much work for me to do that, you know?
Yeah, but how it reacts off the rail.
Okay, so
right?
He's got to make a dynamite shot here. Well, unless it goes to the left bottom left corner.
It might,
yeah. It looks like it's kind of spread a little bit.
We might try
and
break into it.
Must be, yeah. It goes. Oh, look at this. Oh, bank to the side, side. With just a touch of hit it at... Hey, Colin, we're going to hit this one at about, 7 o'clock. You know, let's kick it a little bit.
Which, inside or outside
it
English?
Went that way. Oh, Jesus. I didn't think it went.
That's all she wrote, guys.
Yeah, that's all she wrote. Very well done. I'll tell you what, though, Mungrel, you know, he was playing 20%, if that, of his game. He just wasn't fluid, you know?
Mm.
Just couldn't get a roll on because he is deadly. You know, he'll win 4, 5, 6 games in a row, you know, if he's
three reckons. So what's going on? Is it more than a race to 11 now? Or did we get the score wrong?
Maybe we got the score wrong. I wouldn't doubt it.
Well, let's
we'll check. Hey, Jamie.
Sorry about that.
Jamie. Jamie, what's the score? It's finished. Oh, okay, it's fun now.
Oh, they're finished. They're just going to have a hit.
It's just fun now. So
yeah.
It is. Jamie did win 11-2. So I'll put you on the single one now.
Okay.
So just again reminding everyone, Jamie beat Mungrel 11-2, race to 11 for $400 pot. So we're now back on Travis and Jason's game, and I didn't see actually who won on that one there.
Yeah.
Now they've stopped.
But
so
it looks like there may be a little controversy. Nah, can't be. What do they
want us to scroll back and have a look and see.
Yeah, good idea.
Okay, let's have a look. Okay, I'm having a look at...
Looks like Travis now. Won it.
I think they're just deliberating on it. Trav's about to run out on red and black, I think, looking at the replay. Yeah, and if he does, then it should be 7-4, but they've stopped, so maybe we missed a frame. He had two shots. So he just put the black closer to the pocket. Yeah, okay. And... he went to shake his hand. So, guys, apologies if it's 8-4 already. It looks like it is, and it's all over. So it actually was 7-4 and gone to 8-4. So I'll fix that up now.
It was a good match. You know, he was in it. You know, he had a shot. But, Travis and it's a tough guy to beat. Travis is one of the best players in Australia when he's going good. There's not too many people that you know, he can't handle.
Yeah, definitely. So again, just reminding everyone about the issues with not having pool stat here, trying to keep the scores going on both games, commentate, and get all the technical stuff working. So just bear with us if there are slight issues with the scoring. Travis did win 8-4, race to 8 for $500 pot.
Is there any more coming up, or is that it?
So that's it for the money matches on stream, everyone.
It's been fun. Thanks for all the people with the live chat. You know, thank you for everyone watching. And if you have any advice for us,
yeah. Look, if there's anything we can do better at all, yeah. The stream, the sound, the video, the switching between the, you know, whatever you think can be better, let us know.
And Double King, thank you for watching the stream. It was our pleasure to do it.
Yeah, thanks to everyone for watching the stream. It's really good to see. I love putting something out there for people to watch. So,
yeah, it's great. Thanks, Greg.
Anyway, everyone, have a good night. And
Greg, you can get off the couch and go to bed now, buddy.
Okay, everyone, we're gonna
take care. Bye bye.
Bye, everyone. We'll stop. We'll be back on Sunday. For